Hi there, welcome back to From the Vault. My name is Joe and I'm with Flag Raiders Paintball. This is episode 26. Today we are going to look at the Tippmann Model 98. For anyone that started playing paintball or has been involved in paintball for the last almost 20 years, Tippmann has been a very, very big part of it. So what many of you may start off with or seen was the Tippmann Model 98. This was Tippmann's foray into the mass-produced semi-automatic paintball marker. This came out obviously in 1998. The 98 still keeps the feed neck that everyone is so familiar with on their Tippmann 90 Model 98s that they use now. What's neat and different about the 98 is the fact that it is not upgradable. You could not put in a double trigger. You could not put in an E-trigger, and you could not put in a response trigger because there are no accommodations for it. Tippmann, recognizing this as being a potential obstacle, they added the Tippmann Model 98. This gun, or marker, sorry, came out as a completely upgradable and customizable marker. It did have the allowances by the addition of a plastic trigger guard. You could put in a double trigger so you could have the speedball or the rapid firing. There's also an allowance for the piston for the response trigger, and of course inside the grip are accommodations so you could put in any of the e-grip. They moved along and you could also put in the response trigger, or Tippmann came out with the aftermarket cyclone feed, the same feed that was common on the A5s, but the A5 did not come out till 2005, and Dennis Tippmann, being a paintball visionary much like myself, recognized that in the future he may design a gun that would accommodate what would be called a cyclone feed, which would be an air-assisted rapid feeding system with a low profile hopper, which would revolutionize the recreational and scenario paintball game marker. Partway through, at model number, I think when they hit the 500, when they hit the million or the 500,000 units, they did a slight modification and they redesigned the barrel so it would take a slightly different thread. However, still accepting the 98 common large size barrel, which is common on all 98s. Also, when they went from the 98 to the custom, they dropped the shark fins. I think the Greenpeace and some of the aquatic aquarium associations didn't like the shark fin on the side, so they took that off. In 2006, Tippmann introduced their 20th anniversary marker. We have a couple of these left. Obviously, they're from the vault. We keep them in the vault because they are gilded. Came up with a slightly longer barrel. They added the gold accent screws and a gold hose. Different branding. This, you may have seen a couple of these last night if you watched the VMA awards. So a couple of the rappers were using 98 20th anniversary ones to accent some of their awards. This is the 98, very similar, just they've taken all the standard black hardware out and put gold in. There were 3,000 of these made and they all came with a certificate of authenticity signed by Dennis Tippmann himself, so that's pretty awesome. This is number 612 of 3,000, so a little bit of paintball history. Tippmann then, last year, they introduced the Tippmann Platinum Edition 98, put a Picatinny rail on the top so it could accept different sights, lights, lasers, things that a lot of players will upgrade. They also made an integrated sling mount and a traditional back cap so you could put a sling so it would hang from your body. What really is great on this particular model is the fact that to change the bolt or the hammer or change a sear, you don't have to split the whole clamshell like you used to. You didn't have springs flying everywhere. So you just undo simply 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws. The body half comes off. Do a quick tune-up, maintenance. It's fantastic for field or even the recreational player. that wants to clean out his gun if he's been playing or she's been playing in a sandy area, has some grit or grime, or you need a quick change, lubricate your gun, you can quick change it. So that's the, this takes us to where we are now with the Tippmann in 2011. And I'm Joe from The Vault, and we will see you next week.